This is part 2 of a series on gradient boosting method, GBM. In this video, we will analyze the GBM's regression algorithm. This video was produced in Korean and translated into English. And the audio was generated by AI. Text to speech. In the previous video, we looked at the training and prediction process of GBM's regression through a simple example. In this video, we will analyze GBM's regression algorithm in detail and compare it with the results from the previous video. The training and prediction process of GBM regression seen in the previous video can be expressed in a standardized algorithm as follows. This algorithm looks quite complicated. Let's analyze it step by step using the example used in the previous video. We have data like this. X is the feature and Y is the target value. And there are a total of n data points. The loss function we will use is expressed like this. Where Y is the actual target value and F is the predicted target value. This algorithm can be applied to both regression and classification. In regression, the mean squared error can be used as a loss function. And in classification, cross entropy can be used. Depending on the loss function, this algorithm can work as regression or as classification. Here we will look at the regression algorithm using the mean squared error loss function. Step 1 calculates the initial prediction. The example used in the previous video is like this. For the initial prediction, we used the average value of the target Y. In this algorithm, the initial prediction is expressed as follows. Let's use this formula to calculate the initial prediction. We use this mean squared error as the loss function L. The formula is to find the gamma value at which the sum of the loss function is minimal. Where Y is the actual target value and the gamma is the predicted Y value. Therefore, the mean squared error can be expressed as follows. Now let's find the minimum value of this loss function as gamma changes. If we differentiate the loss function L with respect to gamma, the result is as follows. So we can write this equation like this. Since the gamma is a constant value for all data points, we can write it like this. Calculating the gamma from this equation is as follows. This means the average of the overall target Y values. So the initial prediction is 71.2, which is the overall average of the target Y. In conclusion, this expression in the step 1 indicates that the initial prediction F0 for all data points is calculated as the overall average of the target Y. In step 2, repeat the process below M times. Step A calculates pseudo-residuals. Use this formula to calculate the pseudo-residuals. The first subscript denotes the data point number, and the second subscript denotes the iteration round number. Since this expression is somewhat complex, let's look at the meaning of this formula through a simple example. Let's take the case of the first data point of the first iteration round. Let's replace the subscripts in this formula with these values. Let's substitute 1 for all subscripts I, and 1 for M as well. So this part becomes F0. Since f, x, is f0, replace f, x, in this formula with f0. Then we can write the residual like this. Here f0 is the predicted y value from the previous round. And since the loss function L is a mean squared error, we can write the residual like this. Differentiating this equation with respect to f0 gives, where y1 is 88, which is the target y value for the first data point, and f0 is the initial predicted value of 71.2. Therefore, the residual for the first data point is 16.8. That is, if you subtract the predicted y value from the actual y value, this is the residual. This is exactly the same way we calculated the residuals in the previous video. In step A, the residuals of all data points were calculated as follows. In step B, these residuals are used to create and train a regression tree. We use regression trees because we train residuals that are real numbers. Regression trees should also be used in GBM classification algorithm. Let's assume the generated tree is as follows. Create the terminal region in this tree. Terminal means leaf node. This tree has 4 leaf nodes, where J is the leaf node number. The terminal region, capital R, is denoted as follows. The first subscript is J, the leaf node number. And the second subscript is M, the round number. R2, 1, represents the second leaf node of the tree generated in the first iteration. In step C, for all leaf nodes, we compute the gamma, J, M. The formula for calculating gamma, J, M, is like this. The Y in the loss function L is the actual Y value. And the latter is the y value predicted in the previous round plus the gamma we are seeking. This is the sum of the loss functions L over the data points belonging to a terminal region, capital R. We're looking for the gamma that minimizes this sum. This formula is also difficult to understand. Let's put the numbers in subscripts. Let's only look at the first leaf node of the tree we created in the first round. This is the first leaf node. This leaf node contains the residuals for 2 data points. The third and sixth data points belong to the first leaf node. If we also use the mean squared error for this loss function L, we get the following formula. We only consider the data X belonging to the first leaf node. Differentiate this formula with respect to gamma to find the point where the slope is zero. The result is as follows. Let's substitute the numbers from the example above into this equation. For the first leaf node, I is 3 and 6, and X, I, is this list. And Y, I, is 56 and 57. Substituting these values into this formula gives F0 is 71.2. Here, this value is minus 15.2, which is the residual of the third data point. And this value is minus 14.2, which is the residual of the sixth data point. The sum of the two residuals is equal to twice gamma. Gamma then means the average of the residuals belonging to a leaf node. So, in step C, the gamma is -14.7. This is the leaf value, which is the new predicted residual of the data points belonging to the first leaf node. And in step D, we update the predicted Y value. FM-1 is the predicted Y value of the previous round. We update this value with the new prediction. Alpha is the learning rate. J is the leaf node number. Let's use this equation to calculate a new prediction Y for the first data point. The first data point belongs to the fourth leaf node. So it can be expressed like this. Let's only look at the case where the first data point, I, is 1. If J is 1, the indicator function I, is 0. This is because this data point does not belong to the first leaf node. I is also 0 if J is 2. And if J is 4, then I is 1. Because this condition is true. So, for the first data point, we only need to consider the case where J is 4. F0 is 71.2 and the learning rate alpha is set to 0.1. And gamma is the leaf value of the fourth leaf node. Since there is only one piece of data, it is still 16.8. So this result is 72.88. This is the predicted Y value of the first round for the first data point. That is, the initial prediction for the first data point was 71.2. Which has been updated to a new prediction of 72.88. The new prediction is slightly closer to the actual target Y value of 88. These results are identical to those in the previous video. If we express the GBM algorithm in this standardized format, we can see that it is exactly the same as the training and prediction process we saw in the previous video. And this algorithm can also be applied to classification, which we'll look at later. So far, we have analyzed the standardized algorithm of GBM through a simple example. In the next video, we will implement this algorithm in code. We will implement GBM and SGBM algorithm. And we will compare the results with scikit-learn's GBM library.